Hi guys. Memory card's nearly full, so I'll make this fairly quick. You'll be glad to know. Part two of this little carriage stop. Quite a lot of fiddle. You know what it's like, some small parts you've got to fiddle and piss around with until you get them right. So we're nearly there, but thinking about the few bits I've got left, a couple of holes to tap and a couple of little tightening bolts to make, and possibly a bit of hardening in some way to the boss end that connects with the ball bearing tipped probe. So it'll hopefully be fairly short. It's basically functional in most respects apart from the holding bolts. So anyway, that's about it. I won't bore you with any more. Fingers crossed for you guys in California. I seem to mention the weather every time, don't I? We've got ridiculous warmth. 62 today. I got the bike out and took a nice ride. Talking of which, if it's nice later in the week, I might get some footage in our local Bedford town. And I'm still planning to go and see this machining guy, Dick. I said I know him, but not that well. But I've hopefully talked him into a little interview and tour of his old shop. Anyway, that's it for now. And nothing on the end. So I'll say thanks for watching. And hope to complete this and see you fairly soon. All right, bye. I thought, all right, one more stage. we've got to get a 3/4 relief through here. I don't know whether you'll see, there's a short line down there, which is my target. And because of the step on this, we've got a 300 packing block. And it's all done up nice and secure. The 3/4 I want on here is not actually super critical because I've got to make the adjustment wheel yet, but I've got so few large milling cutters, really I've got very little choice. So I'm going to use this roughing end mill to get rid of the main material, and I have got 1/2 flute, quite a new cutter I think it is, so I'll perhaps put that in at the end and take 1 to 2 thou each side to clean up if I need to. So this is going to take a light cut, see how it behaves. Yeah, not too bad, but again, as usual, be patient. Lighter cuts, wear and tear on the machine and cutter, etc. So we'll press on. Still small cuts. Time to clear up some chips. Oh God, the freaking wind's come up. Probably not as bad as the folks up in New England. And this is a final 25, which I think will get me to where I want to be. I I think that should be enough, because I'm going to change cutters and try and just do a little finish. Yep, I've got about 5 thou spare, so I'll finish off with the this two flute, which is the only other choice I've got. I have to manage with this two flute. It's taking 5 thou off the bottom, and then we'll take a couple of passes for the sides. Now I'm trying to take about a thou off the back side. I don't think a thou will be quite enough, but we'll try and see. More like about 2 thou, I think, to get rid of those ridges. Well, the sides have cleared up fairly well. I didn't go any deeper, there's still a little bit of evidence of the roughing mill, but we're good on that. So you can put that through, and then this is where the adjustment collar has to go. That'll be the next job, I think, to make that. And then we've got to drill the top in two places, make a couple of locking bolts, which I think I will, instead of brass tips, I will use a couple of leather plugs, because it's got to be able to not only not damage the ways, but it's got to actually hold. And we'll see how that goes. Right, we've got to make the adjustment collar wheel. So we'll make it to suit this width, which I think I'm going to make it 765, 763. And then the depth here, I was shooting for basically 3/4. But to make sure I've got clearance at the back, we've turned this down to 740, which leaves me 10 thou all round, 5 thou clearance at the back. I didn't bother with the camera on, actually. I've just put a 2564 down there, because we've got to put a thread in it, and I think I'll get that threaded first, and then we'll do the outside. Right, from the main diameter here, this area we want to put a knurl on, and then from here almost to the end is going to be where the engraving is going to be, and I've got to reduce that by 86 thou, so I'm going to take 43 on the radius. I'll just take a few cuts and get close to it. whether this will be enough. It's only a small amount. This is what protrudes just beyond the edge of the block. I should have about another 3 thou to take off, I think. Let's see what we got. That's 660, just over. So I'll take 2.5. I want it to be a fraction under, if anything. Six, five, five, that's what I want. Half a thou under, that'll work, I think. And then, before we put a knurl on, just going to turn a tiny bit on the face there. I'll do that in a minute. This is basically a very small relief, so the engraved graduations will just have a slight gap from the mark on the block. Right, so really just want to get, I've got one or two edges to break, which will do last, I think. So I just want to put some knurl on here, but before that I'll make an undercut. Just putting a groove in the back here, slightly plus on the length I want, which I will finish probably last of all, I think. I think that should be enough for the knurl, which I'll set up. Right, last pass on here. I have a hell of a job seeing what I'm doing, because it's small diameter material. But we're gradually picking up on it. I think that'll probably suffice. Oh dear. Yeah, I think we're okay on that. I was using the spindle handle, which I usually do when I'm knurling, particularly on a small area. So this just needs cleaned up and wire brushed. Yeah, it's deep enough. Right, well, the next step, I might as well just describe it. It's going to take a while to set up. I made this expanding arbor to go in the spindle, and this end takes this modified gear wheel. I discussed this years ago in some of my earlier videos. The gear was turned down, grooved, and making careful calculations, embedded 100 ball bearings. And then there's a special detent, and I don't suppose that will show a whole lot. It's a special profile for this one, so it goes in between each ball. Now, this is to save using the rotary table or dividing head in the mill. If I index here and go every two turns, and then I'll set up a tool on the tool post to make my engravings. We'll see how it works out. I'm not at all sure, but we'll try it. and I'll come back to you when I've got that underway, I think. Right, got the dividing wheel set up, and this is slow, very slow. And of course there's a burr at each end, that's got to be cleaned off. So I'm going to go around to the next even number. Got to set up very carefully. The plan here is, I've written out a cheat sheet so I can remember what I'm doing. I've got to go around again once I've done the short scribes, and every fifth one reset the stop and make them just longer for the 5 points. I don't think I'm going to stamp the numbers. I should probably use an engraver, which won't be very good for clarity, but it'll do for seeing where I am when I'm using it. So I'm going to carry on. Getting bored. Right, I don't focus in much more than that, otherwise it'll go blurred out, but maybe you can see that. My lines are about right for width. They looked a bit wide initially because, of course, you get a burr down each side. But I'm quite pleased with those. Now I've just got to break this edge very, very slightly, not much, and chamfer on the edge of that knurl. So I'll do that off camera. I'm going to be careful setting it up. All right, so we've got just the tiniest little break on that edge. Put a decent chamfer there. And this side, I haven't quite chamfered all the way yet because we've got to part off, and then I will probably reverse it and finish it to the exact fit. I think that's the best way. Right, we'll see what length we've got and make some adjustments, hopefully. Only small ones. Right, well, that was an absolute fiddle, but it's come out all right. Quite pleased with the marks, and I hope I can engrave it by hand and not be too damn ugly. Might be I can put some stamps on it, I don't know. Doesn't leave me an awful lot of space. I've got 2 or 3 thou there, which is good, because this end I'm probably going to do what Tom's Techniques did, and that's to drill a, it'll be a 332 in fact, because I found a 332 ball bearing, to take a spring and a ball which will bear against this side and give some tension. And then the other thing, which I haven't done yet, is to mill a slot in this thread and put a little set screw in here, because obviously at the moment everything rotates all together. So we'll have to do a little bit of milling in there. Might get away with a 16th, I don't know. I've got some fairly small end mills. So that's two things yet to do there. We've got the, I call it a detent ball. It's not going to go into any slots. It's just going to run under tension and mill this thread. After that, two holes in here and a couple of adjustment bolts, screws, so there's quite a bit to do yet. Before I disassemble this, I thought I'd show you what it's like in situ. That's the expanding arbor tightened up, so that holds the gear wheel, call it a gear wheel still, index wheel, and then the other one holds inside the spindle. And then there is the detent, and the end, which probably won't show, I don't think, I'm too close. It has a point and two concave surfaces so that it'll lock nicely between a couple of the ball bearings. All right, so that did the job. Saved a mill setup. Right, we've got to put a keyway in this thread as a guide, to use a guide set screw. I've only got this is an 1/8 three flute end mill. I've only got two of them, so I'm going to be awful careful. I've set it up in an ER16, and I've just taken a trial shallow cut. Keep your fingers crossed. I hate small end mills. It doesn't actually have to go full length, but I'm doing it anyway. I'll just take the last 1/10 hour or so. I think we'll be deep enough at this stage. I'll have a look in a minute. I don't know whether there's enough light on this bit. Let's have a look, see. Right, this is an idea again from Thomas Technique. So I'm going to drill down 200, which I think should be all right there. Yeah, that should work. And that's going to take a small spring into 332 ball bearing, which I'm hoping will give enough tension for settings, you know, to keep this fairly firm. Should be 200. Well, I'm going to put another hole in because although that's halfway, the ball is not quite into the block enough. I think it'll work, but this will give me a few thou extra. Right, just over 200 deep. I'll try and show you. That's the first hole, I think. And it's a bit close to the edge of the block. And then the other hole, if I can find it, is slightly better. Just putting a tapping hole in the block. Whoa. That's not running very true, is it? Well, I had to make do with that. It was the only 4 mil I had on hand. So I just got a little chamfer on there, so I'm going to tap it now. I'm using 2BA, one of the old British threads. All right, well, this is running okay in here. I guess there might be, well, there's a little bit of movement, not very much. That set screw there, I had to set up and machine to get, what was it, 100 thou length of eighth diameter. So it's pretty close. Now the other thing here is, we've got the one of these holes is better than the other, and getting the ball and spring in is going to be a one-shot thing, hopefully without losing the bits. And before that, I don't know whether you can see, it's oh, magnetic. Yeah, there's a spring in the ball, which I must try not to lose. I don't know whether they even show. Yeah, the next thing I've got to do though, I dug out my number punches. They're a bit big, so I'm going to use my diamond engraver by hand. It won't be very pretty, but it'll serve a purpose. So I'm going to try and get that done next. Well, here goes nothing. As I said, this is probably going to be pretty ugly, but it'll serve a purpose. Now I've got to move around. Not the prettiest five I've ever seen. I'll carry on and get the others done. Well, my memory card's nearly full, and I think I was going to keep this to two parts, but I've still got a few bits to do. I think we'll call a halt on it on this, and I've just got a little piece of well-used paper just to try and smooth off these crappy figures. Yeah. So they're not very pretty. I guess I can read them. They're there for reference. All right, well, that's it till I get to the next stages. Right, well, there we are so far. It's working fairly smooth. I don't know whether the figures are legible. So, although there isn't a lot left, it's enough for me to want to do it as a part three, which will finish us off basically. It's interesting that Tubal Cain, Mr. Pete, he happens to be making one right at the moment. And what he's done is he's got a complete bottom half, which is bolted up, and actually is probably a better clamping method than I'm using. But we'll have to see if the bolts I'm going to make will do the trick. So we've got to have, and I mentioned them before, we've got to have two holes fairly well apart, because they're going to have little T-bars for doing up by hand. And the other thing which I've been thinking about, Pierre actually made a good suggestion, because I was thinking, oh well, I'll put a case hardening on here, because the probe has got a ball bearing which is hard. What I might do is to use a mill to make a pocket and cut a very small slice of drill rod and cement that in and clean it up. I've yet to decide on that. So we're nearly done, just a bit more to do yet.